the fact that yesterday night, I mean, several civilian families choose to come back to Kobani from the so-called safety in Turkey. They chose to come back to Kobani. This really speaks for itself that, you know, people consider this a place to bet on. So the resistance of YPG and YPJ, I mean, it's made up of just normal people, locals from Kobani and some volunteers from other places, and they're fighting with the same kind of weaponry that's, you know, a lot of other people are using in other parts of Syria or Iraq against Daesh. But what people here, I mean, the fact that people here have been more successful in using these weapons and been fighting with a different spirit than all other people against Daesh, proven by the fact that this city is still in the hands of the locals, the most part of it. This shows that people, I mean, this proves that people here have chosen to fight not only for the city, but also for something bigger. And that's, of course, the fact that this city and other cities in northern Syria have been self-ruled by the local populations, not by the regime in Damascus, and not together with Daesh, but by the people themselves. And you know, I think this shows somehow that they are fighting both for the ability to govern and control their own lives, and also for some values that now has proven to be very popular in the Western world where I come from. Values of humanity, democracy, human rights, against beheadings, you know, for women's rights. These are very honorable values and human rights that most people sympathize with.